Hello friends, how are you doing? In the video of today, we will learn together how to apply for visa for Colombia step by step. In this video, we will be explaining the visa policy of this country, how to fill the application form, how and where to apply for the visa, all travel rules due to COVID-19, all the required documents that you will need while applying, and in the end, we'll ask you a question that we will discuss together in the comments. So make sure you watch this video till the end. But before we start, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and if you have any inquiry or question, please write it down there in the comment section below. If we will look together at the visa policy map of Colombia, we will find that all the countries, almost all the countries of South America can enter Colombia with the ID card, but there are many countries who can obtain, not obtain a visa on arrival, who can access Colombia without visa, like almost all the countries of North America, all European countries, Russia, Australia, Malaysia, only Indonesia and Philippines, and in Africa only Morocco and also United Arab Emirates. But for the rest of the world, if you're applying from Egypt, Algeria, South Africa, if you're applying from India, Pakistan, Iran or China, you will need to apply for visa in the Colombian mission in your country before traveling to Colombia. So to apply for visa for Colombia, first you have to fill the online or the electronic visa application form from this site. I will leave this link down there for you. First, here you will read this clarification. Okay, then I have read, sorry, then write your passport number, nationality. Let's say I'm applying from India, for example. Choose your country, whatever it is. Date of issue of your passport, let's say the beginning of this month. The expiry date, let's say that date. Okay. Authority that issued this passport. Okay. Indian government, for example. First name, middle name, last name. Okay, if applicable, date of birth. Okay. Okay, for example, this date, a country of birth, let's say India. Okay, application date, which date you register. If you don't know, you don't have to give. And the clarification, then click continue. Okay, and in this section, you will start filling all those fields, starting with, okay, the application. Okay, the visa type, you want a visitor visa. Okay, authority of the visa. Okay, wait, activity of the visa. Okay, just airport transit, just tourism. Yes, application type individual, name of applicant, main applicant. Okay, applied by the foreigner. Yes, okay, not agent. Then click continue. Okay, passport. Then give the passport the applicant information, personal data. Okay, male, marital status, single. Do you have another nationality? No. Do you have children? No. Academic level, let's say, okay, postgraduate. Acknowledge area, let's say whatever it is, this field. Sub area of knowledge, let's say this part. Date of birth, okay, the date, okay, we're already giving that. The country, okay. Last address date, data, last address data. Okay, so let's stick to India. Insert at least three characters. Okay, Okay, so let's try to Delhi. Delhi. Delhi, okay. Address. Telephone number 00123456789. Okay. Type of housing. Okay, this one is not obligatory. Address. Information in Colombia. I will be staying in that city, Bogota. Hopefully I wrote Bogota right. Yes, Bogota. Expected address in Colombia, this place. Expected telephone number. Write your hotel or your hostel. Okay. Office phone. Type of housing scheme. Okay. Let's say other, because it will be hostel. You don't have even to choose it. Expenses by the applicant. Social media sites. Do you have any social media sites? I will say no. Okay, here write your email. Okay, here also. Then click continue. Employment information. Host. Activity in Colombia. Just tourism and host. Would be the name of the hostel. Earlier application. Have you ever had a Colombian visa? No. Have you ever denied a Colombian visa? No. Have you ever been subject to a cancellation or a no admission for Colombian visa? I'll say no. Then click continue. Okay, additional information. Have you ever been expelled from Colombia? No. Have you ever been deported from Colombia? No. Have you ever had legal panel? No. Have you ever stayed in Colombia without visa? No. Do you have had an immigration card in Colombia? No. Do you have a family in Colombia? No. Health information, COVID-19. At the time of filling the application, are you outside Colombia? Yes. Have you been to China, Italy, France, Germany, United States? No. And then click continue. Okay, then in this section you will have to upload your supporting documents. Let's check the supporting documents that you will be needing. First thing you upload, you need is your photo. Upload the photo from the desktop. Okay, I uploaded this one. Okay, accepted. Then the first one, copy of your passport, date, data page. Okay, add, select documents. Hopefully things are shown. Yes, select documents, travel planner. Okay, passport. The format is PDFs. Are giving you all the regulations about uploading these documents. Okay, has been uploaded. Then click back. So this one is uploaded. In the border. Okay, bear in mind that the order of the documents could affect the result of the application. So be careful with this. Copy of the last entry and exit stamps of salvo conducto where appropriate, or copy of the documents that demonstrates regularized migration status in the country of residence is different from nationality. No, I'm sitting in my home country, so this I'm not applied because I'm applying from my country. Copy of the last Colombian visa if given with I don't have. Duly notarized power of attorney if visa. No. If the visa application is sponsored by the applicant or other person, first letter signed by applicant or by the person that sponsoring the which must include complete identification of the applicant or of the sponsor as evidence in the passport or ID documentation, explanation of the ties with the foreigner, motivation of the trip, and declaration of economical responsibility for the living and travel expenses of the foreigner. Second, bank statement of the applicant. So you need to submit first a letter signed by yourself stating what? So identifying yourself, like you need to write a letter. My name is blah blah blah, my passport number is blah blah blah, I am traveling to Colombia for the purpose of tourism, and some more information about yourself. My work is like that, and I'm planning to stay for this period. Any information, and if you have any contacts there. And also you will need to get a bank statement to upload also select a document. So let's assume this is a letter, for example. Okay, I need also to add another document. The other document is, as I said, the bank statement. I just want to make sure that, so you have to make those two documents in one PDF document and upload it only once, right? Okay, I just was making sure if you can upload several documents at the same time. Okay, if the visa application is sponsored by one or various entities, letter signed by the legal representative, no, not applied. If the applicant is sponsored by a private institute, no, demonstrate financial solvency with the presentation of bank statement at least 6 months. Okay, so bank statement is already applied. Okay, additional documents are required. So in this section you can upload your hostel booking. It's very good to upload it, and your flight tickets, your flight booking also. This will support your situation. All right, let me upload something. Just let's assume this is the paper they need. Okay, and after filling all these parts, click continue. And in the end, you are in the part of the confirmation. Okay, to check the payment method, okay, you will have to go through this link. I will see it now. They will tell me page not found, but I will tell you how to find it. Going to fulfilling the application form. Okay, this link. Okay, I already filled. Everything is filled. And in the end, current location, Delhi, for example. ABC. New Delhi, Nueva Delhi. They're writing it in Spanish. Then click save. Select the office where you, then okay, then your visa application has been registered correctly. The registry code, if your application, this is your registry code, remember, control C, let's save it here. Please record this code for the update of your application. Okay, the process, the application, the consulate, payment, and here you can choose the payment. You can pay in the Colombian card electronic payment, no, or you can pay in the consulate, or you can make a credit card payment if you want to pay for the visa application. So you can apply either in the consulate or in by using credit card. Let's choose credit card and then click continue. Okay, and in this section they want your application number. Okay, and you click the card. First I would like to check something first. I'm sorry, let's say I'm applying in the consulate and then click continue. Last in New Delhi. Okay, so from now you can pay in the office your application code with this number, consulate in Nueva Delhi. Okay, block, this is the place where you have to pay. Let me return back again. Let's say that I'm paying in using credit card, then click continue. Then I will choose visa or credit card. I will write the code. I'm not a robot. Click postcard. Okay, sadly everything is in Spanish, but table of document, passport, the number, your passport number, nombre completo, your name, telephone, your phone number, el correo electrónico, your email, conferma con el correo electrónico, email, then click continuar, continue, then okay, this is the price you will have to pay. So this is the price in the Colombian peso, I believe. If we change it to USD dollars, it will be this number. Then you click on this page where you will make your payment. Okay. Department. Okay, I will leave everything. País, Colombia, identification, reference number, then click postal code. City. Again, postal code 12345. Then click here for payment. Error. Continuar. I think there are some problems here in this site. Okay. There is some error, I think, with this site. They are recommending to use any of these things. I think cancel. And then I will think, okay, let's just go back. Okay, as we did in the beginning, so I think we know that there are two options. The first one is to pay electronically and the second one is to pay in the consulate itself. So I recommend you to make the payment in the consulate, since this option already exists, because while making the payment online it is a little bit confusing. I tried just to show you the reality, what you are going through, either you're trying to pay by yourself in the consulate or trying to pay using your credit card. So the details are not really clear in the credit card site. So just do the payment in the consulate or in the embassy itself while applying. And let's see the travel rules to Colombia while during COVID-19. After application, they send you an email. The first section is in Spanish, the second section is in English, and they give you the details of the payment, the online BSE service payment through this link to pay using credit card and or MasterCard using this link for Sudameris Bank counter at their office in Seda Norte. So in this, okay, those are the details. If you are going to pay in the Colombian consulate, you will have to provide the payment method directly with the corresponding consulate office. So you will have to contact them first before doing that payment. You just need to call the consulate office in your country and check either you can make the payment there in the consulate itself while submitting all your documents. So once this application is done, your application is recorded, you just need to go to the consulate with this reference number, and using this reference number they will check your application. You don't have to print an application form, and you have to attach it with all the documents that we will be mentioning in the end of this video. So of course, due to COVID-19, there are some regulations, so all foreigners without permanent residence in Colombia who didn't complete their vaccination, they should show a negative PCR test with no more than 72 hours, or an antigen test taken no more than 24 hours before departure. And also all international passengers must fill out check MEG from form available from Migration Colombia website or app 24 hours before departure. So this is the site over here. Okay, apps. Okay, let's choose a language in English. Okay, make your check MEG. Okay, this frequent traveler check MEG login. Okay, make your check MEG. Okay, and here city of departure. Okay, entrance to Colombia. Okay, city of entry of the country. Mean or transport to the checkpoint. Okay, by air. Dear user, consider the following. The migration can be done. Okay, no problem. Okay, then choose first. You need to choose the airport or by land or by. Okay, then entrance to Colombia. Then the airport. Choose the airport. The flight data, and fill all your data here in check MEG before traveling to Colombia. And those are the main regulations that you need to take into consideration before traveling to Colombia. So what are the travel documents that you need to prepare before applying for the visa? Speaking about your passport must be original, and it must not be older than 10 years with at least 6 months of remaining validity, and with at least 2 blank visa badges for the stamps. In many cases, you will need also a passport photocopy. It might be one copy or more than one, and it's preferred to be colored, and both data badge and photo badge must be shown if separated. In some cases, you might be required to photocopy every single page of your passport, but in general only the data page and the photo page are the needed ones. Speaking about the personal pictures, you will need at least 2 personal pictures. Sometimes only one is needed, other times 3 pictures are needed, but in general there are only 2. They must be new, not older than 6 months. It should be clear and show your full face, and it is preferred to be with white background, and you should give normal and neutral expressions. No head or face covering is acceptable except for religious reasons. Speaking about the visa application form, form, in general cases you need only one copy of the visa application form, but sometimes you might be required to submit two copies or even three. Visa forms are different from a country to another. In general cases you should print it and fill it manually, but many countries now are providing their application form in an online platform, so you can fill the application form online and after that you can print it and sign it. Anyway, for the application form you just fill it as we do in the video. In most of the visa application processes you will be required to provide a proof of status. For example, if you are an employee, you will have to provide a letter from your employer or from your HR department mentioning your name, your work detail and your salary. And both address and contact numbers should be mentioned also in that letter. And all letters must have an original signature and a stamp. But in case you are the owner of the company or you run your own business, then your commercial registry and your tax card must be presented. But if you are a student in a school or a college, an enrollment letter should be provided from your university or your school. In some certain cases, you might be applying from a country different than your own country. At that moment, you will need to provide a proof of a legal status, which is a certificate of legal residence in this country. And in some cases, a valid residence visa for this country can be also accepted. You will also need to provide a proof of sufficient funds, which is a bank statement stating your balance for at least 6 months. The original bank statement must show your name and should be signed and stamped by the bank representatives. And remember that cash will not be accepted as a proof of fund. You should also provide a flight reservation. It could be an initial booking, but in some minor cases, you will need to provide a confirmed booking. And remember that this flight reservation must include a return ticket. So let me show you a short tutorial in how to book your flight. And we will use this site, skyscanner.net. Alright, starting with our site, this part is a little bit boring, but we will see what we can do. First, you have to select what type of flight you want, a return flight, like two ways going and returning, or one way flight, or multi-city. And let me show you an option. If you would like to change the language, you can change it from here. You can choose your language, you can choose your country, you can choose your currency, whatever fits you. Alright, so assuming that you have, for example, a travel plan, you're moving between different cities, so you can choose this multi-city option. You can add different cities here and you can adjust your dates, date of arrival, date of departure, and you can book all these tickets at once, which is a very great option. But let's just assume you're moving from only one city to another and you want to have a return flight going and turning back. So assuming you are going from Istanbul, of course you can choose whatever you want, if it's in Istanbul or Surat or whatever airport it is, and returning, what is your destination, where are you going? You're going to Delhi, or you're going to Tbilisi, or whatever, Georgia, Tbilisi. And here you will have to choose your departure date, and here you'll have to choose your return date, and here you have to choose your cabin class. Are you going on economy class, premium economy, business class, first class, or what? And you're an adult, okay. You have any children with you? All right. And here, okay, now you can search flights. Once you click search flights, all the flights will appear in front of you. You can choose whatever flight you want. You can go with the best or the cheapest or the fastest, but it's almost the same here. But of course the price will change depending on the destination, and also will change depending on the date. So let's click this flight, for example, and now will appear in front of us. Let's check the details of this flight. And for this flight you can book it from different sites. You can book it directly from Skyscanner, or you can go to any of those sites to book it. But yeah, we will book it from Skyscanner, it is the cheapest anyway. Let's click book. But wait, before booking, let's see the details of each flight. Okay, it's a direct flight from Istanbul to Tbilisi, and it's a direct flight from Tbilisi to Istanbul. So by clicking on these arrows you can see the details of each flight. Let's click book, and here you can see the dates. Okay, you're going, departure, okay, going, returning, and the date. And now click book. So once you click booking, your trip appears in front of you and the total price appears in euros. Why? Because they set their prices here in euro in Skyscanner. So now you can see the details. Okay, you have one cabin bed, you have one checked page. Now let's click next and see more about the details and the checkout. So in the end, what you need to do is to add a contact details, which is an email and a phone number, and after that you will have to add a traveler, which is your name, your middle name, your last name, and in the end you will have to click pay. And by clicking pay, you can do your payment, and congratulations, you booked your flight. You will also need to provide a proof of accommodation. It could be a confirmed hotel reservation, or an invitation from a host in this country, or an invitation from an organization you are visiting in this country. For a hotel or hostel, an initial booking is acceptable, but in some minor cases you might need to provide a confirmed booking. And anyway, the name of your hotel must be mentioned, and the address and the contact number. But in case you are invited by a person, either the letter of invitation should be mailed directly to the embassy, or to be submitted by you, accompanied by a copy of the passport of that inviting person. There are different sites that you can use to book a hotel or a hostel, but let me show you a fast tutorial how to book your hostel from booking.com. So this is our site, booking.com. First, you have to specify where are you going. Let's say I'm going to Istanbul. I want to have Istanbul. Okay, I'm traveling. Okay, for example, check in. Okay, let's say at that date, and check out. Let's say at that date, and I want one adult, one room, and let's click search. All right, by clicking search, okay, they are giving me all the locations, and they are giving me the price here in Egyptian pound. Let's assume I would like to change my currency. I will change my currency from here. I will choose USD dollars, and now the prices are here, USD dollars for the full period. Those things in this site will help you for your choice. You can filter by your budget or your popular filter, or health and safety, whatever interests you more, star rating, whatever it is. But there's an interesting option here also, that you can arrange all of these things depending on price if you are a low budget traveling person. So we can rearrange it according to price lowest first, and let's see the price lowest first for the full period, and you can see that we are having very good prices in somehow okay good quality. Also, we can see, also we can check for better quality. Okay, still good price for very good quality. Let's check availability. Okay, I like that one. It looks old, and only 5 beds left at this price. So you are booking a bed in dormitory and one bunk bed. See availability. Once you click see availability, the whole apartment or the whole place appears in front of you. You can see all the details of this place, and you can here start choosing the availability, like you can like change the dates. And the most popular facilities here, that non-smoking rooms, free Wi-Fi, 24 hours front desk, terrace, and heating also, because sometimes Istanbul gets very cold. They are also giving you here some selections, like for example bed in male dormitory room, and you can see all the details here, like okay, air conditioning, free Wi-Fi, shower, toilet, heating, hair dryer, and of course if you want any other option like comfort, double or twin room, or classic double or twin room, or standard treble room, whatever you want. But let's just go for the cheapest and select only one bed. You can select of course more than one bed, and they give you different things like free cancellations and no prepayment needed. You can pay directly at that property. So if you, in case you would like to cancel it, they are giving you a specific time and a specific date. In that date, till that date, you are free to, you can cancel this booking for free. Just click I will reserve. Once you click I will reserve here, you are filling your details. They are giving all the booking details. It is for 4 nights, and this price is $35, and here you will have to enter your details, all your details, and bed in male dormitory room. Okay, you'll have to give your full name and if you have any special request or something, and also here give your arrival time. So you have just to review all these parts, and in the end you will click final details. By clicking final details, you will review again all your details and you will confirm your booking. Once your booking is confirmed, you will receive an email in your email like that, stating the check-in details, as a check-out detail, as a duration of a stay, the phone number and the address of the place and all the details. And this is the page that you will have to print and take with you to the embassy while applying for the visa. Many countries, also especially the Schengen area countries, require you to provide a traveling insurance, and you have to be careful and to apply through the companies that are accepted officially in these countries. For example, in case for Schengen area countries, there are some certain specifications for this travel insurance, like the insurance coverage must be at least 30,000 euros, and in general cases you can apply for this insurance online. Now let's look together as a travel insurance company. Those are some travel insurance companies. You can use any of those websites to apply for the travel insurance, but since I know that travel insurance is a little bit confusing for most of people, I selected two companies and we will see together how to apply for travel insurance through those two companies. Applying for travel insurance is quite confusing for many people, but here I selected the site europeinsurance.eu, and let's see how to apply for travel insurance. First, you have to select your main destination in Europe, which is, I selected France, the start date, the end date. Let's say you're just staying for 1 month and you want this insurance for 1 month, and here you write your date of birth, then get a quota. Okay, so now there are two types of travel insurance. The first one is basic and it costs 19 euros per month, and it covers more than 60,000 euros, which is required, because for travel insurance you have to apply for something more than or equals to 30,000 euros. So I will select this one, and here if you want to extend, but just let's keep it like that for this basic one, I will select it over here, and now I will have to fill my details, the insured person, my name, and the policy holder also, if it is the same person, though the same also details, my own details, and important statements, just some statements, and in the end you will get to the payment. So this travel insurance, which will cover more than 60,000 euros for 1 month, it's just only 19 euros. Let's check another site, which is axaschengen.com, which is quite expensive site, and here they give you different periods, like for Schengen low cost, Schengen Europe travel, Schengen multi trip, get a quota. Okay, so for the prices here, okay, let's first you need to click get a quota over here for the cheapest one. Okay, and here they will ask you the Schengen low cost, they will ask you about the start date and the end date of your travel. So my first date is this one, all right, 12, and my last date, let's say, will be 11th of April, also for 1 month, and this one for 31 days, and it's a little bit, it's not a little bit expensive, it is expensive, and it covers only up to 30,000 euros. But you know, the difference is sometimes about the rate of the company, and also the categories they are covering in the travel insurance. But here I'm just showing you how to choose, how to apply, because this is, because choosing the category, the options, is something depending on you. But many people are just having some problems, what is the travel insurance, how to apply through the travel insurance. So all these other details I will leave to you. I'm just showing you how to apply through the site and what is the real cost of the travel insurance. By saying 30,000 euros, we don't mean that you should have this balance in your bank or to prove that you have it, because some people think so, those who are not really having experience with travel insurance, then here you click continue, and after you click continue, you click here for the subscriptions. You will have to fill all your details, and after filling your details, you will make your payment, and in the end you will get a confirmation of your travel insurance. And that's how you apply for travel insurance through this website.